Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Game 1. The team is going to set the stage and your very own Bobby Sport. Your team is going to set the stage tonight in goal number 1, Nash Woods. And number 77, Alex Murray. And forward to the stage tonight, with number 4, Matthew Schneider. Number 8, Connor Harrison. Number 24, Lauren Fred. Number 25, Maxwell.
Welcome to another weekend of NZIHL Hockey. I'm Dr. J, joining Bryce Rouse here at The Hive in Auckland, New Zealand, between just a cracker of a matchup between the top two teams of the table, the Southern Sky City Stampede, playing here against the home Botany Swarm. Now, at the beginning of the year, you would probably expect to see the Stampede in first place, but a little bit of a surprise to see the Swarm right on their back.
Yeah, they're playing very well this season. They're definitely going to give Sky City a run for their money if they do reach the finals. If they do win both these games this week in the Swarm, they'll be pushing right on the heels of the Stampede for that top spot and home ice advantage.
Right. Both of these teams have clinched the top two positions, but we have yet to decide who will be number one, and this weekend will be a big part of that.
Yeah, the Stampede will definitely want to come out and win both these games just to get a good feeling for the finals going into a final week next week.
A few familiar faces on our Sky City roster. We have Colin McIntosh again for his third straight season as an import. The Canadian lad has put up quite a bit of points. A great playmaker on the ice there for the Stampede, and someone the Swarm will have to watch out for. However, on the other side of things, the Swarm have some fairly talented imports themselves, and Daniel Iacenza is actually currently leading the league in scoring. So let's see what he can do out there right now with Corey McEwen winning the draw for the Swarm. Now Sandoy will have it. He'll skate behind his own net and pass it over to his D partner, Andy Hay. Hay will chip it up the wall, and that's up to McEwen. McEwen is chased hard here by Braden Lee, knocked off the puck, and Iacenza will chase. And now Michael Atwell helping out in the corner. And that's Schneider that was trying to break that up, but it's actually gained control by the Swarm, and it's Iacenza again. He'll stop to try to keep some room. Looking for a centering feed here, but instead he'll just skate it to the net himself. There's a shot right on and a huge save. Rebound and another save by Alex Murray. A very talented goalkeeper here for the Stampede, an import brought in from NCAA Division I college in the United States, and he has been the best goalie so far in the NZIHL statistically.
He'll definitely get put under a lot of pressure here tonight as the Swarm attack is looking promising here so far straight away.
And speaking of goaltenders, we have Rick Perry on the other side who has had a phenomenal year himself. So faceoff will be to the left of Murray. Played right in front, a quick shot there by Vortinov, but again, stopped by Murray with some great side-to-side movement. Now played up to center ice. And that will be Carson Pratt chasing Mawson. Mawson up to Josh Hay, but tries to get it to Kozak, but that's too far in front of him. And now played over, and Freer will dump that behind the net. Carson Pratt, first one there, tries to chip it to his man behind the net, but Josh Hay is the only player. And now he'll go cross-eyed towards Kozak. Kozak almost had a step around Omston there, but then fell to the ice. And now played dangerously in front of the Stampede's own side and finally out of the zone. And here's the defenseman, Omston. Try to play it up, but Chalice will swing in and recuperate that puck, and the Stampede will get a change. Good forechecking there by Harrison as he knocked the puck behind the net. And now Colin McIntosh will chase and then play it up to Polozov. Polozov over to Ollie Hay. Plays it up towards Chalice, but Cameron True gets in front of that and plays it to McIntosh. Now McIntosh up to Strayer, the fleet-footed forward, who now has his Kiwi passport and a member of the All Blacks team. Ice Blacks, the ice of the black.
You never know, he might start playing rugby soon.
Yeah, who am I to crush his rugby dreams? It's now played behind for Polozov. He'll go up the wall towards Chalice. Chalice trying to protect the puck as McIntosh is on him. And then finally taking off his step. He now played up towards Harrison, but that's just in front of him, and it will be an icing all the way down.
Yeah, Botany Swarm with a lot of possession here in the opening stages, really keeping the puck away from the sticks of the Stampede. Stampede will definitely want to get a bit more possession if they are to win this game or even this weekend, as the Swarm are looking good so far.
Yeah, the Swarm have definitely had the opportunities early, and a couple one-timers in front that Murray has been challenged with, but looking solid so far. Now played over towards Strayer. Strayer's able to control that. He'll try to get in towards Harrison. Looked like that was close to an offsides, but play will continue as Sandoy has it, as the Stampede are off for a change. He'll just skate it himself and dump it into the zone. Murray will stop that for Freer. And then up the wall towards McCog. That is Harrison McCog. But too far, and we have another whistle. So the Stampede still trying to get some tape-to-tape passes here in the early goings.
It's good seeing the game start off at a good, fast pace, you know. You know you're in for a good one when you see that.
With two teams of this caliber, it will definitely be a juicy one all weekend. So that's the import Volpe starting play from his own send. Now up towards Schneider. But Atwell is able to get in front of that. He steals it. And then dumps it for McEwen, who just saw a hit coming at the last second, as that was Harrison McCog coming at him. Now up to Iacenza. Iacenza takes a big hit from Freer in front of the Stampede bench. And it's Volpe back to collect for the Stampede. Now up towards Lee. Lee finds Schneider. Schneider with some speed over the blue line. Tried to dish it off to Lee, but a couple of Swarm players got in front of that, and now it's back towards McCog. Kozak skating up himself before he's ridden off the puck by Freer, and the Stampede will start again from their own end. Now Mawson with some aggressive plays. These are for Kozak, and there's a hit right at the blue line as two players collided, and we're getting an interference call here on Mitchell Freer, it appears, and the Swarm will be the first on the power play today.
Yeah, he tried to put a late hit there on Mawson, but the referee saw that one, and he will go to the naughty bin for a couple of minutes, and that will put the Swarm on the power play. First one of the game. Definitely looking to something to do with this.
Yeah, it looked like a collision right at the blue line there. Sometimes that can be incidental, but nonetheless, obstructing a player without the puck is an interference call. So we'll get a faceoff to the right of the goaltender Murray. Puck still got caught under a player there. It's finally corralled by Casey Ball. Now up to Chalice, back to Ball. Ball looking for a teammate. Plays it over towards Chalice, but that pass bounced over his stick. And the Swarm will have to regroup and back into the zone as Paul is off. Paul is off, tries to go around Omston, but Omston had a good stick on that puck, still giving him some trouble in that far corner.
Yeah, they got Chalice sitting at the back post there looking for a pass.
And finally it does come to Chalice on the end wall here. Chalice looking for something, throws it on net, tipped, rebound is loose, and finally cleared all the way down. Good strategy there from the Swarm as a tip in front, a misdirection, but could not find the backdoor play for the open goal. So just under a minute remaining here on the man advantage for the Swarm. It's Josh Hay making some moves. Plays it up towards Ollie Hay, then a shot right on. Rebound was right in front for Iacenza, but it just popped away from him with a good defensive stick work there from Amston. Now Hay again. There's a tip and another save made by Murray. Atwell will find Hay. Ollie with another shot, and Iacenza once again got a piece of that, but Murray was there to make the save.
Yeah, the Swarm looking like they just want those redirect tips from low shots along the ice. Try to get Murray off guard.
Now Ollie Hay will skate into the zone. Finally cleared up and out over the glass, and we will get a whistle.
Swarm looking relatively well on the power play. About four or five shots from it. There's 4 seconds left on the penalty, as Freer will be looking for an outlet pass, as he might have a little chance at a breakaway if he comes out at the right time.
So the Stampede will win the draw and throw the puck all the way down. And just like that, we're back to 5-on-5 hockey as Freer is out of the box. Sandoy now with the Swarm. He's looking for a long pass towards Chalice, who's just in and onside apparently. and then played in the far corner. That one was going towards Max McCaug, but it just bounced off his stick, and the Swarm will put it back deep into the Stampede's end. Now Freer has it as he's chased by Chalice. Back to play for Perry, but that puck actually got stuck in a rut right next to the ice and the boards there. So an unusual play on this ice surface. And finally back down for Andy Hay behind his own net. He'll go D to D to find his man Sandoy. Now Sandoy with another long pass looking for Kozak, but that gets past him. And we have an icing call as it looked that Kozak was neck and neck chasing for that puck, but apparently just a step too slow.
Yeah, it was a very close call, that one. Wouldn't want to be in the referee's shoes to try and make those icing calls for the man trying to beat it out.
The rule is beating your man to the dot. So it definitely looked like Kozak was the first one to the puck, but he might not have been the first one to the dot as the refs are indicated. So we go cross-eyed here to Vortanov. He's got a seam to work with. Vortanov with a shot, but that's blocked by Cameron True, who was able to backcheck and just get a piece of that. And now Schneider tries to get around Josh Hay and does. But it's played up towards Kozak, and he tries to get it in deep, but can't get it farther. Then the defense went in. We're back out to center ice. Now Kozak will go into the near corner, and it's McEwen there to chase, and Cameron True. And now McEwen is able to scoop up the puck and play it over towards Mawson. Mawson trying to get around Schneider, but he was having none of that. And now play back to Amston. Amston plays it up. And then back to Hay. Hay over to McEwen. McEwen up towards Atwell, but Connor Harrison was able to break that up. And now Harrison pressuring the defenseman. And McIntosh, just straight out of the box, is able to intercept a pass with his first stride, and he'll just take it himself. Now up towards Harrison. Harrison going one on three here. Gets around one man and tries to get around Ollie Hay, and then is pressuring in the near corner. Now centering feed there was dangerous, looking for Strayer, but just got through him. Now Amstead again. Up top to Harrison. Harrison with a shot right on, but that's blocked by McEwen. And here comes Iacenza with a nice little dish from Atwell. Iacenza gets around one man with a great stick work before the other defenseman is able to knock him off the puck. Now Chalice has it. He'll avoid a McIntosh pressure and play it back towards Sandoy. Sandoy over to Hay. Hay plays it back to Sandoy. Sandoy, a little bit of speed there, but McCaug was able to knock the puck off him. And now the Stampede collect. Freer knocks that one out of midair towards Max McCaug, but he was unable to play it. Now played all the way back, and it's Sandoy. Carson Pratt on his back, so he's forced to play it over to Fraser. Fraser up to Chalice. Chalice with a spin move, as Freer is pressing him. And it's over towards Sandoy again. Swarm unable to break it out after a couple attempts there and have turned the puck over, and now possession is back with a Stampede. We're able to put it all the way down to get some fresh legs out there. So another chance here for the Swarm with some soft pressure from the Stampede, and Polozov just takes it himself, and now he's got some room to work with. Looking for a centering feed, but that hits True, and a rebound attempt by Fraser is blocked. And then Josh Hay on Harrison McCaug is able to jar the puck loose, and it's Vortanov who leaves it for Fraser. Fraser with a long shot. Rebound comes right into the slot, but Carson Pratt is able to get a stick on that and play it out. And now Fraser, as Harrison McCaug was pressuring him, plays it up towards Volpe. Volpe, there's a shot from Schneider in the slot, but that deflects just wide. Now Braden Lee with a centering attempt. Puck is paid right into the slot here, but no Stampede is there. And it's up to Kozak, who takes a hit from Volpe. Now Volpe has it. Waiting for some help from Schneider. And Schneider tries to go around Kozak, but he's able to get a skate on that. Now McEwen with a step. McEwen over towards Moss and back to McHugh, and there's a shot. I don't know if that got through, but a great opportunity for the Swarm. Now Iacenza enters the zone. He tries to get some stick work. Then a centering feed and a shot right on by Iacenza, and a stick save by Murray. So a little back and forth action here as things are starting to open up a little bit here in Botany. Ollie Hay will throw it in deep, and Atwell will be the first one to pressure. That goes up the wall towards Strayer, and he's trying to find Harrison. And now Harrison pressuring, but that's knocked off him and up to Atwell. Now the Swarm the other way. Atwell leaves it for Chalice. Chalice right on. Rebound over towards Zandoy, but a great defensive effort by Harrison to keep a shot from going on net. And it's Iacenza on the far wall. Amston is able to knock the puck off his stick before the Swarm are able to regain control, and it's Polozov. Polozov absorbs a hit from Strayer and just keeps going, and then a little stick move fooled the defender and gave him a little bit of room to dish to Chalice. Chalice pressured by Max McCaug and has to play up to Sandoy. Sandoy with a long shot, but that hits Harrison and he goes in the far corner. Carson Pratt's the first one there. He played up towards Max McCaug, but he can't control it. And then finally back to Amston at his own blue line. And then up to the end wall. That's played by Casey Ball. Now Polozov. Polozov with a shot right on, but Murray saw that the whole way and is able to clear it to the end wall. Polozov fighting for the puck with Carson Pratt, and they're going back and forth a little bit before the puck is finally taken by Volpe. He'll play it off the wall towards Freer and then gets it right back. Just over 7 minutes remaining here in the first period. There has not been a lot of whistles, a lot of free-flowing hockey thus far.
Yeah, a lot of momentum with the Botany Swarm at the moment as Stampede not really getting into this game just yet.
What would you say the Stampede have to do to generate some more offense?
Definitely those neutral zone passes need to be reaching their man's tape and not causing turnovers in that area.
And here's McHugh with a nice move. He's in all alone. A shot, rebound, and it's gobbled up by Murray on a great save, on a great opportunity from Corey McHugh.
Yeah, stunning save there from Murray. McHugh with a little bit of time in front of the net, try to go backhand and beat Murray at the far post, but Murray was up for that one.
And it looks like we have 12 shots to just one here early on for favoring the Botany Swarm, so they've definitely been out early. And often. McHugh with a little backhand, forehand, backhand move there. And Murray stayed put. He did not bite on it. A quality goaltender here that has really been a good key to success for the Stampede this season, as well as right now, as two Swarm players just get checked into each other. It's Iacenza and McHugh that got a little too close. I know they're good mates, but maybe not that good. And now up to Atwell. He'll try to chip it right in, but that goes right into the shin pads of Dunford. And now Harrison McCaug. He'll play it towards McIntosh in the near corner. And McIntosh trying to play it up towards Harrison, but that's intercepted by Chalice. Now he's got speed the other way. Chalice stops, looking for a feed. Goes towards Casey Ball, but that's just off his stick, and he'll play it to Polozov. Polozov with a long shot. It gets kicked up in the air and gloved by the goaltender Murray for the whistle.
Yeah, the Swarm able to just step into that attacking zone here at the moment, free willy, and just being able to get a few passes going together and get shots off. If they can keep it up, they're looking like the team that could get this one.
Just need to be a little bit crisper with those passes right around the house area. And Strayer has the puck. He'll throw it along the wall, and Perry will be there to stop it. Forced to play it here, but it was actually taken from him by McIntosh.
Wow, that could have been dangerous there.
And now Polozov. He'll play it towards Chalice. Back to Polozov. Polozov tried to find Chalice, but they weren't on the same wavelength there. Nonetheless, it's played up to Andy Hay with a shot that was deflected in front and never got through. Now McIntosh again. He'll slow it down and call for Volp to come through. And now Volp will have it. He tries to find True. And then back to Volp with some open ice here to skate. Across the blue line. Still looking towards the center of the net. And we're going to get a slashing call here. There's a shot right on. Rebound! And a big save there by Rick Perry to keep his pad in front of that puck, as that was a dangerous opportunity for the Stampede.
Yeah, Volp able to skate around Logan Fraser, and he didn't want him to get too close to the net, so a bit of a hooking call on him. So he'll serve a couple minutes in the box as Queenstown will get their first power play of the night. See if they can get something going, get some shots, more shots on the board.
And a dangerous power play nonetheless here from the Stampede. So it'll be Schneider to take the draw. He wins it to Dunford, who plays it over towards Volp. Volp tries to center and feed towards Iacenza. And he was looking for McEwen, who was actually breaking on a shorthanded opportunity there, but that pass was just out in front of him.
Penalty for the Botany Swarms, number 24, Logan Fraser. 2 minutes
for. Now played up to McIntosh. McIntosh with the puck on the near wall. Takes a hit from Ollie Hay, and he goes to the ice. Puck still loose under McIntosh, and it's going to be a hand pass as McIntosh played that with the mitts.
Yeah, Ollie Hay just able to hit his man to get him off the puck. Forced him to try and make a hand pass, but referees have been pretty good so far here, Doc.
Right you are. Just two penalties assessed thus far, and the Stampede have a minute and 20 remaining on that man advantage. The Swarm have been dangerous this year shorthanded, scoring multiple goals while short a man.
I think they almost have more shorthanded goals than power play goals.
That might be true. And now McIntosh with the puck. He'll play it up towards Dunford. He had to make a diving play just to keep that off the stick of Kaluzny. And it's Atwell. Atwell going one-on-one with his man, but he is knocked down. Puck still loose. But Volp was able to get a good shoulder into him. And now cross ice, it's Strayer. Strayer puts on the brakes, awaits for help as the Stampede get a change. He'll put one right on, but Perry's able to get a blocker on that and throw it into the far corner. And again, all the way down, as Polozov will chase Omston, two ice blacks. Going at it here, plenty of talent on the ice all around from both sides. And now Amston. Amston puts one on, and a big glove save by Perry to hold on to that one. With just 20 seconds remaining on this power play for the Stampede.
Yeah, Amston not getting all of what he'd liked on that shot, but Perry was able to match up with that.
Flashing a little bit of leather. We've seen that a few times this season from Perry.
I've even seen you flash a bit of leather there, Doc. You're pretty good when you suit up in the goalie uniform.
Oh, I thought you were talking about my chaps. Nonetheless, here we have Freer from the point. He'll put one towards the net. But that's over the stick of McCaug and then up to Amston, as Fraser's out of the box. And we're back to 5-on-5 play, but we do have three defensemen on the ice for the Swarm. So now Hay has it. Still jostling for position behind the puck before it's finally cleared over to Kozak. Kozak skates right into Braden Lee, so he just dishes it off to Ollie Hay. Now Ollie will play it up the ice. No one there. And finally back in.
Yeah, Lee having a bit of a go at the referee there.
Yeah, he was not too thrilled with the referee's positioning as he was trying to get a change and some fresh legs out there for the Stampede. And now Polozov, 2-on-2 with Chalice, with McIntosh to back check. Shot right on, gloved and finally covered, and then Polozov is taken to the ice by True, and then a little friendly tap on the back of the head there.
True might go to the box for that little extracurricular activity there. And
And I will see if the refs do call that, but it looks like they are not. True will stay on the ice. So a long shot and a save there from Murray. He has looked really good tonight, but if there's one thing he wants to clean up is maybe some of these rebounds. But you can't argue with a zero-goal game at this point. Now the other way, it's Strayer trying to get the puck, but Polozov is able to steal that from him. And then Andy Hay makes a play as he collides with McIntosh. And then KC Ball the other way, one-on-one. Centering feed looking for Chalice, but that gets through everyone. And now up to Sandoy. He'll just backhand it in towards Polozov. Polozov has a little bit of space here. He'll just stop on the end wall. Polozov with a nice pass to the far corner looking for Chalice. Chalice gets around one man with a little bit of space, trying to find Polozov. And now up to Sandoy. Sandoy thought about a shot and instead passes it to Polozov. Polozov throws that one right at the defender, Dunford. And then over to Harrison McCaug. McCaug from a sharp angle right on, and Perry is able to gobble that one up.
Wow, that was offside by a couple of strides there by the Stampede, but the ref definitely missed that one as he was well in the attacking zone when he received the pass.
And it looks like Perry is cleaning off his face as he might have got a little dirty from a spray there from McCaug crashing the net. Doesn't seem too thrilled about it, but I'm sure he'll be just all right.
Yeah, he's a good battler. He'll be up for it. Doesn't go to sleep too, old Perry, when doesn't have too much work to do in the start of the game or whatnot. Always alert, always stays on the game.
And now in the end wall, that's Harrison McCaug. He finds Schneider. Schneider tried to for a centering feed of Braden Lee, who was all alone back door, but Perry was able to break up that pass. And now Harrison McCaug avoids a hit from McEwen, but still battling for the puck as we have Schneider helping out as well. Atwell with a diving play to try to force that one out, but unable to do so, and it's Mawson and McCaug. McCaug not able to do much with that, and it'll be thrown the length of the ice by Ollie Hay. And we will get a brief respite for this swarm line who has been out there for a long shift.
Yeah, Stephen Mawson loving to throw a bit of hits in the far corner there, using his body size very well, try to win the puck back for the Swarm.
So that is some of the best puck possession in the offensive zone we've seen thus far from the Stampede, and they'll put out just a top-end line here with Schneider, Strayer, and McIntosh against this tired Swarm line with McEwen. So maybe an opportunity here. There's a wide open in front of Strayer, and he knocks that one out of the air and puts it on, but Perry once again is there to make a save, and that'll be it for the end of this period.
Great opening encounter here so far in Botany. No as they'll head to the dressers.
But it looks like the referee might be calling a penalty as time expired in that first period, as McIntosh is having a discussion about something that happened. It looked like perhaps Mawson's stick was on the ice at the end of that, so we may be getting a 2-minute minor for slashing. We will confirm that when we return here for the second period. But a lot of action thus far, some free-flowing hockey. What are you looking forward to in the second?
Definitely now that two teams know a bit about each other, should be some more open hits in the second period as the game will open up. Stampede definitely need to get into the attacking zone a lot more and get some more shots on net as they're struggling a little bit in that department. But the Swarm, I think they should just relatively stick to the same game plan as this first period, and they should come away with a couple goals by the end of it.
It was a good period for the Swarm. They definitely were out shooting their opponents, but so far nothing to show for it, as still a 0-0 game. So, stay tuned, hockey fans. We'll return here in just a short 14 minutes.
No real pressure from Swarm attackers as they'll break that out. Higgins with a bit of speed. He'll go into the blue, but good stick there, I think, by Sandoy it was. And the Swarm are coming the other way in the form of McEwen, who gets past his man, puts a pass in the middle, shoot, and they score! Michael Atwell on the tap-in.
Looking just like last night, getting an early goal, get on the board. Might see another high-scoring game again tonight.
As Ollie Hay will try find Kozak, but he gets a little piece on that and icing is waved off. Good forecheck by Hopkinson to do some damage as Morgan will have a step in. He'll put a wrist shot on net, deflected in off Kozak, and they score. As Casey Ball will go to work here against Hopkins. Mr. 200 today, old Casey Ball.
Oh, just
and
trickled
it trickles in.
In.
It's a goal. Zaya Sens will give that to Ollie Hay. Very dangerous, this line for the Swarm. And Morgan was at the back post. He was just unable to get a shot away. And he'll find McEwen at the back post. He'll give it to Iacenza. He scores!
Sullivan had a short trip to the box, I guess. And battle for the puck on the point. Ooh, hit by Barakauskas there. Fraser passes it way left for Johnson. Oh, shot on, and that was scored. That was scored by Richie Hopkinson. So we've got the two players with their milestones scoring a goal this game. Puck behind the net. Matt Atwell intercepts again. And a hit there. Mawson collects the puck, pinching in the zone. Behind the net, passes to Iacenza and scores. That will be the second goal for Iacenza this game. Diving play, Bob Yaw style almost. Over to Ollie Hay. We'll put on the brakes. Morgan collects it, skates in.
Swarm on the power play now.
Yep, they'll have a power play for just over a minute. Plenty of time to score. Over to Iacenza. And that's the hat trick for him. That's the hat trick. Sullivan puts it in. Puck goes in front of the net. Nothing interesting happens though. Johnson collects the puck, passes it to the center to a Red Devils player. But Kaluzny manages to get it. Oh, tries to put a shot on, but it's stick save, I think, by Goss. Ball makes a move from the corner. Goes in front of there and scores! Second goal by Casey Ball. The Red Devils actually have changed their keeper. For this period, Neil Fanning, 21-year-old. This is his first season, actually having some ice time.
Prinsloo unable to control that. Point pass as Kaluzny will skate it up ice for the wrist shot on net. He goes 5-hole and scores! Rick Perry didn't see too much of that, but he did deflect it wide. And Sandoy with a good steal. And he'll go for a bit of a skate. Casey Ball, another pass back to Sandoy. Backhand scores!
Another shorthanded goal.
Hit the post as Barakauskas will slam on the brakes and find Vortsnov in centre ice, but he was unable to corral that as Rees will gain control. Tries to bang off the boards, but Vortsnov was read that. High slot shot from Vortsnov. Scores! So having the confidence to actually try these kind of passes in the attacking zone is a good thing to have on any team. As Mawson will try and make a nuisance of himself in the attacking zone, and Kozak will pick it up. He'll skate around. Finds Vortsnov in the slot, and as easy as that, he puts it over Fanning. And that's it, folks. Botany Swarm with a 12-goal win.
Let's start off with what everyone probably wants to hear about. You're rocking a pretty mean hockey face at the moment. You got stitches, bruises galore. But that recent fight against Alex Gauthier, take us through that. What spurred that all on?
When you're not the star player of the team, you're always looking to make improvements and do something for the team. So we had a player get a high stick, which sent him off to the hospital. And pretty much I just asked him what the number was and told me the number, and I had a look for him, and somehow it happened. So I know the rumors say that I was the one that shouldn't have been there, and that I was backing off left, right, and center, but let's just put the story straight. I was the guy to ask him, so good on him for taking it. Not so good my end for getting knocked out in one punch, but what can you do? It's just the sport, I guess.
The New Zealand Inline Ferns have wrapped up their campaign at the 2019 World Roller Games with a thrilling playoff for 11th place with neighbours slash rivals Australia. And now this is one way to leave your goalie high and dry. Hannah Shields is left all alone in front to open the scoring with a beautiful one-timer set up by Jasmine Horner-Pasco. 1-0 is how the score would remain for the first half, before Horner-Pasco sliced through the Aussie defence early in the second, showing off the hands that served her well this year with the Ice Ferns.
Oh, what a beautiful goal.
Shields is another dual international with the inline Ferns. She bagged her second of the game, assisted by Ashley Cunningham.
That is 3-0 New Zealand.
Australia managed to answer back with one, but it wouldn't be enough to stop the tide rolling in New Zealand's favour. First, Helen Murray slotted the puck home for a sneaky shorthanded goal, much to the surprise of Aussie keeper Janice Wheeler, and then Jana Cavell sealed the deal 2 minutes later.
Oh, what a wonderful individual effort.
Putting a whopping 41 shots on goal compared to Australia's 7, the inline Ferns were in control throughout, winning the game 5-1. For more New Zealand hockey news, stick with Puck Year NZ.
To Amston. To Strayer, and Strayer taps it into the corner. Strayer takes a shot. Oh. Big
off
bounces
the
in front.
Inside post. Gossa did not quite make the initial save. The puck bounced off the inside post, and then one of the Canterbury defenders was cognizant enough to whack that out of the danger zone.
Stewart dances away from one Canterbury player. Back to Freer. Freer takes a shot off him. Off a pad and off a post, and again from Freer. Just peppered. And Dumford just takes it behind the net. Around to Stewart in the corner. Stewart behind the net. Centering to Schneider. Schneider to Dumford and batted up. And Eden, dangerous dude to leave.
Now that went in, I believe, before the contact between Eden and the official.
Shorthanded goal by Canterbury.
What a breakaway there by Chris Eden.
Hard
now, of course, Eden is one of the players who, the last guy in probably this entire league that you would want to leave open on a breakaway like that. That was a breakaway opportunity by Matt Schneider. Play just flying down the other way.
And here's Reese on Freer. Freer easily takes that away from Reese. Puck rolls in front, wide of the net, and fired up and out. And here's a chance for Amston. Amston comes out of the box. Amston for scores! Booyah, baby! Amston pays back the penalty that he got in spades. Says hello to Goss. Tap to the corner again. Back to Amston. Amston with it now. Fires in front. Didn't even see his save, but Goss made a save. There's... in front of the, oh, in front was McLean. Puck bobbling in front. Leaves to the corner for Stewart. Stewart with it now. Over the blue line, over the red line. And fires. Puck bounces in front, in the skates, tapping around. Amston can't keep it in. And that ends his big shot at the last second of the game. He's got Schneider with him. Puck, Stewart. Dumford forced to reach for it. One time, a beautiful save by Goss. Picks that up and tapping it around, and Goss gobbles that up. Wow. Amston with it. Cross ice to McIntosh. McIntosh back to Soffer. Soffer cross ice. And Strayer off the post. Strayer controlling behind the net. Strayer still trying to dance and tap it. Finally! Finally! Strayer. McIntosh, finally.
Canterbury's starting to look a little bit frustrated.
Front. Can't do anything with it. In front of the net, pushed off the puck as the puck just floated. Unattended here. Schneider with it. Schneider takes a shot.
Whew, what? The big windmill there from Goss.
I don't know. Is he landing aircraft with that? That big wing of his. And Stewart gives chase. Stewart tapping past Sullivan. Stewart centering past, tapping it in. Spectacular, spectacular save and cover up. I believe that was Sullivan. Big flick pass across to Lockie Freer. Lockie Freer taps it into the corner. Lockie Freer goes, takes behind the net, wins that. He's centering past it. Mitchell. Oh, Mitchell Freer off the post. Finally, Mitchell Freer. Freer to Freer and in the net. What we would like to see. Lockie Freer and Mitchell Freer. What a brotherhood. And Soffer fires it. And putting it in.
The hometown team would be proud of their performance today. That was a well-fought match there for Sky City. They really struggled in that first period. But
well, I don't know. I would say they did struggle, but Canterbury came out with all guns a-blazing. He's got McLean with it now. Over the red line. Skates over the blue line. Dances behind the net. Looking for the centering pass. She scores! On to McIntosh. The Mick to Mick. Sullivan to the neutral zone. Banks with it now. Banks, fresh legs. Backhand. Puck bounces in front. Shot scores! Big rebound. McIntosh carrying behind the net. Trying the wraparound. Puck in front. Still tangled in the feet. Dumfert with it now. Dumfert faking the shot. Dumfert skates to high. Scores! Little bit of a tapple, do ya?
That signature fake and then shot from Dunford, it works more often than you think it would.
Lead pass to Soffer. Soffer over the blue line. Soffer carries to the corner, back to the point. Amston lining it up. Scores!
We have goals in back-to-back games for Stefan Amston now.
So we've got McCaug centering Carson Pratt and Lockie Freer.
And back to even strength.
Freer across to Amston. Amston over the red line. Fired. Oh, it's good! From the red line! Amston! Oh, my goodness! Sullivan over the blue line. Feeds to Monk. Monk over the red line and fires it in. Looking for that line change. That could be trouble. That line change happening all at once. Lead pass to Stewart off of Schneider's stick. Stewart reaching, getting knocked off the puck, being harassed by Egan. Passing. Scores! A sleepy little slider from Stewart. Serenich of the puck. And now Schneider has it again. Back to the point. Freer, Schneider. Bouncing puck to Stewart. Stewart tucks it in under the pads. Five-hole express. Liam Stewart, unbelievable close. Hand-to-hand battle.
He can pick your pocket and he can plant the evidence on you as well, is what it looks like. That was just a great effort there.
So Banks carries. Banks being harassed heavily by Carson Pratt. Banks carries all the way. Shot. Scores!
What a narrow angle shot.
One man show. Banks carrying all the way from behind his, from in front of his own net, all the way down, being harassed heavily all the way through, but got to take the man. Skates it to the corner. Banks giving him some grief on the corner, but Dunford ends up with it. Centering pass.
Welcome back, everybody. Second period about to get underway as Queenstown Stampede will sit a 2-minute penalty for the start of this period for something that happened at the end of regulation in the first period. So the Swarm will be on the power play as Queenstown will put that in and Ollie Hay will pick this up.
Some fresh ice to work with here for that Swarm power play, so it'll be interesting to see what they can make happen.
As Josh Hay will leave that back for his brother Ollie. He'll look for an option and find Iasenza at the top of the blue, but good pressure on him by McLean, which is actually Volpe wearing the jersey. good stick there by Volk. Atwell will come away with it, and he'll find Corey McEwen, but a good pressure on him. Swarm able to get this into centre ice as Josh Hay will skate into the attacking zone. Goes for a little roundhouse around the net. Schneider pressuring him, but he'll have a shot. But blocked in front, and Queenstown will clear that for the time being.
Nice play by Josh there. He kind of faked like he was going to drop it at the point, but instead held on to the puck, was able to get a shot attempt.
As Kozak will spin around and wait for options. Tried to find Iacenza, but it came off the wall as Remy Sandoy will give it over to Chalice. Chalice will give that back to Remy Sandoy as he'll put something on net. Good pad save there by Murray. Chalice with it will find Casey Ball down low. And I'll go up to the point. Centering passes. Kozak tipped that just over. Pressure on Polozov. He's able to get away from his man for the time being. He'll find Ball. He'll put a shot on net. And good cover up there by Murray.
Murray was able to kind of put himself in that little half V position and just not give Ball much to shoot at all.
So 16 seconds remaining on the Stampede power play. As the Swarm will look to chuck out their second line. Good win by Josh Hay as Mawson will have it. He'll put something on net. Deflected in front, but good clearing there by Queenstown. And they'll send that all the way.
Yeah, the puck was free there for just a split second, but Josh Hay just couldn't get the stick on it.
As Harrison puts a bit of pressure on, and Carson Pratt takes a shot. Good save there by Perry, and the Swarm will clear. So
back to 5-on-5 hockey here.
Oh, almost settling that was Harrison. Oh, and a trip there by... No trip on the play. Ollie Hay just losing his feet there.
Yeah, that very easily could have been a penalty, as it looked like a stick was pretty close to the blades of Ollie Hay, but the refs disagreed, and he did have a pretty good look at it. Ollie, although, is not convinced.
Some good fast play to start this second period, as Schneider will go to work up against McEwen for this draw. Won by Schneider there. As Freer will take that around his own net and find Makarg. We'll try find Lee, which he does, who will bang that in and chase. Good chase there by Schneider, and he'll be the first to that. Tries to find a centering feed, but Jonas Barakuskas was there in a good position, as Atwell will come with this. Pressure on him by Volt, but unable to cause a turnover, as Iacenza will spin away at the boards. Gets past Makarg. Atwell was waiting for it, but just couldn't get a good pass, as that will be deflected into the upper netting.
So we'll get a whistle here. The Swarm have had two power plays thus far, but really unable to get many good chances on either of them. The special teams for the Stampede, of course, is top-notch on both sides, power play and penalty kill.
As Dunford will... elect for the backhand pass, but only goes to a Swarm player. Chalice able to get that back from Sandoy. He'll put something on net, but it's deflected in front. Polozov will be dispossessed there, as Harrison will have it now, and he'll find Strayer. Try to get a centering pass, but it was just blocked there by Remy Sandoy, as Queenstown will still have possession of this. Pressure on... and Polozov will come away with it now. Put a little turn in and leave it up for Remy Sandoy, having some speed. Chalice getting past his man. Unable to find a pass though, as he got a little bit on that.
Delayed penalty coming here on the Stampede.
Might be for kneeing.
Yeah, it's going to be a trip or a knee contact.
Yeah.
So kneeing is the call.
So it'll be Harrison to sit there for 2 minutes on the knee call on Chalice. as the Swarm will once again go on the power play.
Knee in, of course, can be a very dangerous play. So, good to see that the refs are taking notice of that call.
As the Swarm will win that draw, but it will be cleared. Aya sends a good pressure on him by Schneider. As they will ice that. Try send it all the way down, but Ollie Hay in a good position will come away with it. He'll find Aya sends at the blue line, but good stick on by Ampston, and Schneider will come away with it. Backhand, nice pass. He shoots and almost scores.
Huge good save there by Perry, just to kick the toe out on that shot.
Josh Hay will try find a bit of speed and into the attacking zone for the Swarm. He'll go round the back of the net. Try to put on a shot, but a good stick there by Volk. And Queenstown able to clear this. As McEwen will go back into the zone. Kozak on the far post, but McEwen will take the shot. But good save there by Murray.
Murray once again holding great position and was there to make that save and hold on.
Yeah, McEwen did have an option there at the far post for Kozak, but elected to take a shot. Got to back yourself in those situations to find the back of the net yourself. Unless obviously a man is dead wide open. So Casey Ball will go to work now for the Swarm and he'll lose that draw. As Chalice will have it, give it off to Ball. He'll find Chalice again. He'll put something on net. Good pad save there by Murray.
Yeah, Murray saw that all the way.
Jealous almost losing possession with good pressure on him as Remy Sandoy will find Sasha Polozov. He'll look for options and put a little spin on and find Casey Ball with a nice pass. Oh, just unable to find Kozak, but Sandoy will have it. He puts it in front of the net. They score!
And Kozak with a little extra celebration there as he tips a shot right in front to beat Murray. And we have ourselves the first goal of the game.
Good play there by the Swarm, finding the man at the back net and then just putting it back into the center for a good tip-in by Kozak.
I'm not sure how well or how impressed the Sky City Stampede were with that Kozak celebration. But he definitely put an emphasis on it, and we'll see how the Stampede respond.
Yeah, I think he's trying to say first blood to us.
In fact, he might even be getting a penalty or just a talking to for that celebration.
And Lee came over to say a little cheeky words, I think, to the Swarm bench. Don't think they'll take too much notice of that.
In any case, it is a first goal of the game, so the Swarm are finally rewarded with some of their work to date. And they did convert on their first power play.
They did. So they one out of three now. Goal for the Botany Swarm. As Schneider's pressured here by a couple of Swarm men. As Volk will throw that up, and Markarg will bring this into the attacking zone for the Stampede. Centering pass, but unable to find Schneider's stick. Good pass from Atwell to Iacenza as he'll come into the attacking zone here for the Swarm and put on the brakes in the corner. Still with it, Iacenza, but he had a good stick on him. Ollie Hay putting that in, but turned over by the Stampede as McCarg will find Lee. He'll put a wrist shot on net, but good block there by Stephen Mawson. Ollie Hay with a pass straight to a Stampede defenseman, and he'll put that in for a change.
Ollie was just a little slow on that pass. He had a man up ice, but wasn't able to get it off in time and ended up passing it right to the Stampede defenseman.
As the Stampede will come away with the puck and unable to clear just yet, but they finally do. Straight into the hands of Josh Hay, who will rip a shot from just over halfway. And the Stampede turning it over in the far corner. Australia will come away with it now. Try to find a saucer pass, but good snuffed out there by Leif Thompson. Shot by Amston. Good save by Perry as he'll cover that up.
Yeah, nice save by Perry there. Got his body in front of it and then was able to just snatch the rebound out of midair with the glove. And we'll get that face-off just to the right of Perry here.
Yeah, the Stampede definitely taking a few more shots in this period, Doc.
Yeah, we're starting to ease into it a little bit deeper here. But once again, Perry has been up to the challenge thus far.
As the Swarm will win that draw, and Andy Hay will go around the back of his net and give a up-ice pass to Casey Ball, who will clear. As that's put back in with Carson Pratt, the main chaser. Andy Hay will have this. Good pressure on him by Carson Pratt, and he turns it up. But good hit there by Polozov. And he'll get a turnover, and there is a whistle on the play. And it will be Andy Hay going to the box, I think.
Yeah, it looks like we have a penalty behind the play. And Andy Hay was trying to skate to the bench. But instead, he will take an extended rest in the penalty box. I didn't quite catch exactly what happened, but that was after Andy had taken a bit of a hit. He's holding his face, so he may be thinking that the stick got a little high, but whatever he did, the ref definitely saw it and has penalized him that 2 minutes.
So the Stampede now on the power play as Volpe rips a shot, but that hits Ollie Hay, which looked to be in the air area. Good shot, though.
Big save there by Perry, as that actually went off the almost the knob of the stick. But he was in great position to make that save.
So the Stampede sporting their number one power play line as they'll go up against Botany's best penalty killing line. Volpe with it now. He'll find a man in the middle, but Swarm able to clear this for the time being. But good steal back by Dunford. He'll look for options. As he'll find a man there, and they go to the net. The Swarm able to keep that out. As Freer will find Dunford at the point. He'll give it over to Volpe. And Dunford with it now in the slot. But tried to deke his man, as he probably should have taken a shot on that play.
Yeah, definitely. In hindsight, you'd say put that one on net and see if you can get a rebound, because he had two players with him that were crashing the net hard, but made a nice move, unable to get a shot.
So Volpe will go D-to-D pass to Dunford. As Schneider will get a good pass, good deke, back post. Try to put on a move.
Still loose.
And we'll get a whistle on the play as the goalie hadn't have covered the puck up. It is behind the net, but we will get a whistle there.
Yeah, perhaps the...
And we've got a Stampede man down, and he does not look too good here, folks.
No, that's Colin McIntosh. We really don't like to see this kind of thing happen.
Yeah, he's not moving a lot at the moment.
Looks to be in some pain.
Schneider helping take out the trainer there so she can go have a look at the situation. So a big scramble in front of the net there with a great opportunity for the Stampede.
Yeah, I didn't exactly see what happened. There was a nice play by the Stampede, and I believe that was McIntosh who made a good move and got Perry to bite, but was unable to finish the job with the puck loose. And then that's when things started to get a little crazy and players were hitting the deck. And we just hope that McIntosh is all right.
And the Swarm physio will go out there also to have a look at the situation, see if he can assist in anything that needs to be.
And yeah, that's Sonny, the trainer for the Ice Blacks.
don't think McIntosh will be able to play on here by the looks of it, as he's definitely in a bit of distress down there, but he'll finally make his way to his feet. Good to see.
Yeah, definitely still feeling that. So glad to see that he's able to leave the ice under his own power. I didn't see the refs award a penalty on that play, did you?
No, don't think so. There will be one man going to the box for the Swarm, Eric Chung, even though he wasn't on the ice. So it, what would that possibly be there, Doc?
That's a great question. If there was a match penalty, and if someone was ejected, then you would have someone serve the penalty for them. So 5 minutes. So we have a 5 minute major on that hit on McIntosh. I did not see what player has been awarded this penalty.
So the Swarm will have three players out there for at least 47 seconds.
And it looks like that's Ollie Hay that has been ejected for that hit on McIntosh.
Have to watch a replay of that one to see exactly what happened. So Mawson, Polozov, and Sandoy will be out there for the Swarm as we get back underway. As Volt will have it up in the high position, he'll give it over to Dunford. He'll give it back. Find a man in the far corner as Dunford thinks about a shot. Volt one time and absolutely skies that one into the upper netting.
Yeah, definitely didn't get good wood on that. Just got out the nine iron and chipped it up into the netting.
So the faceoff will come out of the Stampede attacking zone. As Schneider will go to work again against Polozov. Good win by Schneider. And he'll leave that up for Volpe. He'll put it down low, trying to find a man, which he does. Over to Dunford. He'll give it back to Volpe. One time shot from the corner. Pad saved by Perry.
10 seconds left on this 5-on-3.
Dunford will find Volpe at the top. And he'll give it back to him. And he'll find Schneider, who will give it back to Dunford. One-time shot, but didn't get much on it. Good shot by Volpe. It came off the crossbar. And the Swarm able to clear that for the time being with a rocket shot from Volpe that just missed by an inch.
Yeah, that was a rocket. Got in close and hit nothing but iron.
And Schneider will whack that run around for Dunford. And just able to corral that on his stick was McCarg. As Mawson will be able to clear that all the way for the Swarm. The Swarm will get a full line change on this. Except, nope, Mawson does come to the bench now. As Dunford will find Amston, it looks, but he'll be dispossessed. As Iasenza will have it now, but on one situation, able to get a shot off, but goes wide.
3 minutes remaining on that 5 minute major penalty to Ollie Hay. So if the Stampede are able to get a goal, they will continue to be on this power play for the full 3 minutes remaining.
As Dunford will find McCarg, who will put on a little spin to get past his man. Good hit by Fraser on Dunford. As he didn't really have anywhere to go as he was turning to face the goal. As Volpe will go for a little bit of a skate. fakes to leave it, and he does just get around his defenseman for a second. Volt making a bit of a nuisance for himself for the Stampede, as Lee will have it now. Pressured by Remy Sandoy, which does knock the puck away from him, but the Queensland will remain in possession. Harrison with it. He'll find Schneider. Schneider, nice little turn pass to Amston. He'll put a wrist shot on net, but straight down the throat of Perry.
So just 2 minutes remaining on that 5 minute major penalty. Amston had a good look there with a shot, but actually put it right into the chest of Perry and he held on.
Yeah, probably needed a little bit more power to get one from that far out.
Or just some traffic in front. But the Swarm did a good job to clear the viewing lane for Perry.
And Kozak will send that one all the way down. And Murray will play that behind his goal for Amston to come pick up. As Stampede will cycle around. And Schneider will have it. He'll cut back inside. Takes it over the blue line. Risho on net. Straight into the glove of Perry.
Yeah, Perry saw that one all the way. Making good use of that glove so far. And a few different opportunities for the Stampede on this power play, but still unable to convert.
A quick shot off the face-off from McCarg, but Perry will block that one as pressure on Remy Sandoy, and Schneider will come away with it. As Volt will have it, and he'll give it back to Schneider. He'll give it back to Volt one time. Traffic in front of the net, rebound, but he puts that wide.
Looks like Sandoy actually might have stepped in front of that as the Stampede had a wide open net to look at.
And Kozak will try put that all the way down, but it looked to be a high stick by Volt. Yes, it was. And we'll get a face-off just outside the Stampede attacking zone. Sorry, it will be moved up to just outside the Stampede defensive zone. So McEwen will go to work here against Amston.
Just over a minute remaining on that 5 minute major penalty to Ollie Hay.
As Volt will find McCarg, who will bring it into the zone and try to wrap that one deep, as Andy Hay will be the first there, but pressure on him by McCarg, and he does come away with it and gets a good pass off to Lee. And Volpe at the point now. He'll find Dunford. He'll find McCarg, but he doesn't get a good shot off. And Dunford with a pretty good hit on Logan Fraser. And Volpe with it now. He must be tired. It seems like he's been up there the whole power play. Yeah, he's definitely looking a little tired. As McEwen will steal that one back for the Swarm. As Logan Fraser unable to find one of the two forwards there for the Swarm.
Yeah, the Stampede had a 3-on-2 chance, but instead they just turned it over. And here's the nice play by Murray trying to catch the Swarm on a change.
As Mawson will have it, and he'll wrap that round and clear that.
And that will be it for the penalty, as Chung actually had some trouble getting out of the box there. Otherwise he might have been able to make a play on that puck.
And Chalice will find that one. Gives it over to Polozov. Always a nuisance in the attacking zone is Mr. Polozov. If he turns his man there, Carson Pratt gives it to Ball, who seems to be upended by maybe a stick lift on the leg.
Yeah, the Swarm are looking for a penalty on that one, but they did not get it.
As the puck goes quite high, and it will go out the attacking zone as Chalice has pressure on him from Freer and Lee. As Freer will put that one in deep, and Sandoy will be the first man there for the Swarm. But Freer will win this back, try to get a centering feed, but Polozov was there. And Polozov will turn and burn and look for a bit of time here. And Chalice will bring that back behind the net. Tried to put on a nifty move, but he's been dispossessed there by McIntosh. Good to see him back out on the ice. And True will keep that in there for the Stampede.
Yeah, definitely great to see McIntosh back out there, and he's a vital part of this Stampede unit.
So, a little bit of a ticky-tack-toe as Chalice will get a good opportunity here as he comes down this near side. Beats his man Harrison, but Harrison just did enough to get him off guard. As that will be icing against the Stampede.
So just over 4 minutes remaining here in this second period, and it looks like the Stampede have come out and put a good number of pucks on net so far, so definitely a better showing than that first period. However, they are short a goal.
That is true. Yeah, they're definitely looking a lot more deadly when they are on the attack. Nothing to show for it just yet, but definitely looking a lot more promising.
And a great job by the Swarm there to kill off that 5-on-3 followed by that 5-minute penalty.
As Kozak will have it, he'll turn and try to look for some options as looked like McIntosh got a, no, sorry, Freer got a stick on that and able to clear. So both teams playing quite open at the moment as McIntosh will have it. Puts on his backhand centering feed, but Josh Hay was there in the slot to clear that for the Swarm.
Yeah, good back check by Josh going right to the net to help out.
As McCarg will have this behind the Botany net. Ampson will put that back in for McCarg and he'll try to look for an option, but he turns. Good pressure on him by Josh Hay. And a little bit of a scrum formed in the centering feed. Oh, Lee just missing. He was wide open there with a great opportunity.
Yeah, that was a great chance for Lee. He was so close to that, it was almost surprised he didn't put it on goal.
He had a bit more time than he realized.
Yeah, tried to make that quick delivery. Didn't realize that there was nobody within a meter of him.
Schneider will find a nice pass up ice to Lee, and he'll slap wrap that around. Good hit on him by Thompson. Centering feed to Schneider, but he just fanned on the shot. They'll get a second opportunity here through Lee, but can't do too much with it as Atwell will look for an outlet pass.
Yeah, good job by the Stampede right now. Getting some guys cycling towards the net and then able to get a couple passes right there. So Swarm defenders should be watching out for that.
Now Lee with it. He'll try to centering feed to Schneider. Unable to rebound. Another shot there from, and another shot there from Amston. So some good pressure here by the Stampede in the last 5 minutes or so as Mawson will come away with it for the Swarm. He'll try to put on a move, but a great hit on him by Schneider as he'll close the door.
Yeah, Schneider with that big frame is able to take down the 6-3 Mawson himself.
And Corey McEwen will have this behind Botany's goal. No real pressure. As Polozov is looking to cycle, but he'll leave that for Barakuskas, who does find Polozov.
Yeah, I'm not sure
luckily
how that squeezed through.
And Iasenza will go to work down low. Couple of spin moves and he gets away from a few players and will find Sando at the top point, but just unable to keep this in. Tides are turning a little bit here lately as Sandoy will try find ball, but he actually lost the stick. And Freer will try find a centering feed, another rebound.
Big save there by Perry on that nice pass from McIntosh into the slot area.
And a little bit of afters, but the ref won't call anything on this as Andy Hay will drop that for Polozov and they'll break into the zone. He'll put on the brakes and do a little shimmy and find Chalice. Good scoring opportunity, but tries to find Casey Ball, who just couldn't get anything on that, and it'll be a 2-on-1 the other way. He shoots, and it just hit the side netting there.
Yeah, the Stampede thought they got a goal there, but it hit the outside of the net.
Freer put something on net, but that hits a skate in front. As Vodanov will pick this up, try to find a saucer pass to Chalice, but that's picked off by Volpe. And we have a whistle on the play.
Looks like too many men call, yeah, as the Stampede had an extra skater out there. on a bit of a sloppy change right in front of the bench there, and the referee was all over it.
Absolutely.
Swarm had a great opportunity previously on the other end with Casey Ball wide open back door right in front of the net, but was unable to convert that pass. Otherwise, this would be a two-goal game.
So the Swarm will go on the power play here, as no one has gone to the box just yet. But it will be Freer, number 24, who will sit the 2 minute for too many men, as the Swarm will get their top line out against the Stampede's top penalty killing line. So Josh A filling in for his brother Ollie. I don't think he's probably playing defensive and forward when it is full strength. But for this power play, he is playing right defenseman as Iacenza will try to make a move, but Amson will get there. Mawson just unable to keep that in as he'll pass it to Josh A, who will find Iacenza. And he'll put something on net, but Murray's seen that all the way.
And that will do it for the second period. A tight one here in Botany as the Swarm have that 1-0 lead, just holding on to it as fending off some of the Sky City Stampede pressure throughout that period.
Yeah, Stampede definitely improving on somewhat a dismal first period, I would have to admit, but they've definitely come out firing in the second period, so if they can keep that up, they're easily capable of getting back into this game.
Definitely. Maybe just shaking off a little bit of travel rust in that first period. And they're looking good. We should see some exciting action here in the third.
Absolutely. We'll take a quick break and we'll be right back in about 15 minutes. Stay tuned.
And Sullivan behind the net. Sullivan to the neutral zone. Banks with it now. Banks, fresh legs, backhand, puck bounces in front, shot, scores! Big rebound.
That was fantastic positioning there by both Chris Eden as well as Monk, the defenseman. It was just sort of a perfect, you had the trailer and then you had the defenseman lurking back there just in case the rebound trickled a little bit further out. Fantastic work collecting that rebound by Canterbury, and we have ourselves a tie game.
One-timer shot and a goal!
It's left Oliver Hay. Puts it over the boot. Take it around behind the net. It's crossed to Morgan now. He shoots. Saved by Chabot. Bit of traffic in front. Comes out to McKeown, I think, number 7. Down for Iacenza to Casey Ball, and he gets it in the net.
A day to Nippard. Nippard for Ladeig, back to Nippard, across for Daig. Steps in the middle, but shot deflected.
Great opportunity there as Perry was down and a little out of position as Daig was moving to the center of the ice, but couldn't put it on net.
That's what they were looking for. And Ladeig with the one-timer blasted straight in. McKeown up to Iacenza. Puck poked away by him, from him by Regan. He's a good young defenseman that's been playing well this year as well for the Admirals.
Aggressive play by Perry to keep that out of Henderson's
stick. Oh, Nippard with the shot! And McLeish back in the corner now. His pass intercepted by McKeown. And now Iacenza has it in the neutral zone. It's up for Morgan. Back to Iacenza. Gets past McLeish, centers it, and shot by Morgan!
Ladeig using that long stick of his to break up that 2-on-1.
Sends a probably better option, just taking the shot on that one. Oh, and that traffic in front, and they get a wraparound goal.
Iacenza puts one into the back of the net.
Fraser just doesn't quite get it out of the zone, I don't think. Did he? No. And Jackson runs into his man. The Swarm bench calling for a penalty there.
Yeah, Kuzny got taken down right in front of the bench there.
Regan gets it for Craig. It's that for Dixon now. On the pass, just in Craig skates as Johnson comes in. He shoots, he scores! He's looking for some options. He's going to skate it up and gives it to Alice. Alice for Daig. Centering scores! So Iacenza in with Harrop. Harrop wins it this time. Oh no, it comes back for McEwen. He's got some space. He shoots. He scores!
Great play by McEwen there to pick up that loose puck off the draw and shoots across his body, glove side, to tie this game at 5. Put some pressure on Iacenza. But Iacenza still has the puck. Excellent move there.
And Morgan is going to shoot it. He does. Deflected, but just hits the leg pad, and now Ladei is going to kick it out.
Great play.
Comes
by
the other
Ladei.
Way. He's going to use his big weight and power, and almost!
What a save by Perry!
And now it's cleared out by the Swarm.
Nice save there by Perry. As they're looking 5-hole on that one-timer. And just 10 seconds remaining on this 4-on-3, but then we'll have a brief 4-on-4.
Ladei doing a good job skating that one all the way up. He's got some space. Centers it, and it's in!
Spiller with the game winner on a feed from Ladei, and the Admirals take the game here 6-5.
Yeah, great play by Ladei to skate that one run all the way up the ice. Couldn't even get the shot off. Throws it in, and Spiller, I think someone might have been there. Didn't quite connect fully on it, but it worked for them in the end, and puck ends up in the back of the net. Their first goal of the game was a power play and second. So two power play goals last night from the Swarm. And there we go. Chalice sends one on, and Kozak was in front. Just tipped that one in past Gershka Margosh. Locking up that center of the ice. And Morgan, nice play to get past Hart. Down low, and McEwen roofs it over the glove of Shaba. I think, was it Morgan down in the corner who found McEwen?
Great work by Morgan down in the corner to free up a little ice and found McEwen right in the high slot, and he made no mistake with that one going top cheddar over Chaba's glove.
Yeah, Chalice brings it in. He's shot, bounces out in front off Chaba, and now Nippard will bring it back the other way. Oh, and Polozov had the stick in the skate, so that's going to be a tripping penalty. Big person in front of you there as it's kicked back by Iacenza and winds up now. Shot score by Morgan. Now Atwell will get it up for McEwen. So Morgan. Morgan now down low, and it's blocked, I think, by Ladei as Nippard runs into Atwell.
Yeah, big
And here comes there. Dixon with a chance in the open, and he scores!
Dylan Dixon on the breakaway beats Perry, glove side, and just like that, it's a two-goal game.
Down for Ellis. He finds Daig, back for Henderson. Will he wind up? He does shoot, but it comes off the skate of Mawson. Ellis looking for Henderson. It bounces up for Daig, and now McEwen has some pace, gets past Daig. Puck was just too in front of him, and there goes Iacenza right in front.
Yeah, Iacenza left wide open, and we have a PK goal here, shorthanded for the Swarm. Swarm fans starting to get on their feet here. They can smell the last seconds.
Ladei looking for a redirection.
Huge save there by Perry on the misdirection in front. Yeah. Was able to kick a leg out there just in time.
He's bouncing all over the show there. Puck and Ladei now for another chance. Saved. And our clock's a little bit slow. Sorry, there's only 3 seconds left now. And that'll do it as they clear the zone. So the Swarm coming away with the victory.
Yeah.
4-1.
Yeah. Yeah, speaking of players leaving, you stepped up for the Thunder and you helped to recruit your buddy Miska Aaltio from your team in Finland. How did that go about?
Well, as soon as we found out that we're going to be short a couple of players, I just sent some messages to group chats of players and former teams that I've played in, and there was huge amounts of interest in many players, but since it's summer, in the middle of the summer back home now, and everyone has their summer jobs or vacations or things pretty much organized already, then it wasn't possible for many guys to come here for just to play 8 games. But fortunately, Miska was available, and yeah, things got on pretty fast, and we agreed. I think it was last week's Wednesday when they agreed to take Miska on the team, and he was in New Zealand on Friday. So things happen sometimes pretty fast, but yeah.
Yeah.
So if you have purchased a puck, please get the sign early and throw that onto the ice easily. And don't forget to rip that ticket off the top. And the closest one to the center wins the cash prize. So everybody, in 3, 2, 1, chuck your puck. Thank you.
back, ladies and gentlemen. Third period about to get underway here at Paradise Botany. The score is 1-0 in favour of the home team.
And the Swarm will be on a power play here to start this third period. A minute and a half to work with. That'll be Moxon. As the puck for the Swarm, he'll play it up towards McEwen. McEwen just overskates it here, so he'll go back to Moxon. And now Moxon will take it into the zone. He'll throw it around the wall. Murray's there to stop the puck. Holt. And he finally played up in front of Murray. So Mawson has it now. He'll play it down towards McEwen. McEwen was looking for Atwell and said he'll just play it behind the net towards him.
Yeah, and the net's come off, I think. No, Murray's put it back. Now the ref did see that.
Yeah, it looked like Atwell just kind of was skating through the crease almost, trying to get that puck and knock the stick and the net off of the goaltender, Murray. So we'll get a face-off to the right of Murray. It will be McEwen to take the draw against Schneider of the Stampede. And we'll blow the whistle here as Iacenza and Volpe are a little early in the circle there.
Yeah, the ref doing the old fake drop to get them dancing before he actually does.
And that'll be cleared all the way down by Schneider. So Josh Hay gets it. He'll play it behind towards Mawson and gives it right back to Josh. Now over to McEwen. McEwen across the line. Puts one towards the net, but that was just over the glove of Murray and off the glass. Now Harrison McCaug will get it. He'll throw it up the ice, but it actually hit Mawson, and it looks like we have a whistle.
Yeah, not entirely sure what for, as Mawson used his glove to bat that down to stop it from exiting the attacking zone for the Swarm, but
could be an inadvertent whistle, which if that's the case, then we will have a penalty here, or a face-off here right in the zone. It's Chalice with it. He'll put it towards the net. Not sure Murray saw that, but it safely went wide. Now to the near side, it's Polozov. McIntosh pressuring him. Now over to Ball. Ball takes a hit there from Dunlop. Now Chalice plays over to Polozov. Polozov with some room. Fakes a slap shot. Gets around McIntosh, but unable to deliver. And he'll just play the puck up to the Stampede. So it's Strayer the other way. 3-on-2 here. Looking for a centering feed. But that gets right through the crease as Freer was coming out of the box to join the play.
Yeah, good decent chance there for the Stampede. Just unable to get that final touch on it.
There's a long pass looking for Kozak. That's in front of him. There'll be a chase of the puck, and Kozak wins it, and then takes a sharp hit right into the wall. And the defenseman here is without a stick or the Stampede. So a little 5-on-4.5 as the defender without a stick there in front. Now pulls off in the far corner. Here to Kozak. Kozak trips up and loses control of the puck, and Amson will just get it, and he'll throw it all the way down. This will be an ice, but it does give the Stampede defender a chance to get a fresh stick. So Dunford will return to the ice with a fresh twig, and we'll try this again.
Yeah, McCaug just trying to be a little sneaky there and go for a change, thinking the ref might have not seen it. But he'll be called back out there by the ref for this face-off for the icing.
So the Stampede will not be able to change personnel on that icing, and we'll get a fresh line out here for the Swarm. And Schneider comes away with it after the face-off, and now it's Harrison McCaug over the blue line. With McEwen, now over to Schneider. Schneider tried a little forehand and maybe got a piece on the rebound, but Perry made stops twice. Now 2-on-1 the other way at the Swarm hustle. over towards McEwen, but that pass deflected up into his second rebound. Here's a chance, a one-timer by Atwell that was right on, and Murray was in great position for that save. There's a centering feed here. Atwell was crashing towards the net, but Schneider was able to knock that from him. And now Atwell is down in the corner, and we have a whistle. I didn't quite see what happened, but this is a result of that collision with Schneider. And Atwell is in some pain.
As the Swarm trainer will come out onto the ice and see what he can do to help the situation for Mike Atwell. As he'll get to his feet.
Glad to see Atwell able to come off the ice here. Looks like maybe he took an awkward collision into that far corner. Did you see what happened, Bryce?
Not exactly, but it looks to be his right leg seems to be in a bit of distress.
So we certainly hope Michael is all right. A key member of this Swarm team, after sitting out the season last year with a shoulder injury, is having a big year on that top line for the Swarm.
Yeah, he's having a hell of a season so far. It's good to see him coming back to what he was after shoulder reconstruction surgery.
So now Josh Hay will get it. He'll play it back to Mawson. Mawson up towards Kozak. He tried to deflect that in the zone, but instead just gave it right to Volpe. And now Volpe going the other way. Defender still with the puck. And now he'll go behind the net. Centering feed here is broken up by Mawson. And then finally tipped up towards the center ice and out. And now Barakauskas has it. He's got two players on his back, and he'll go D to D towards Mawson. And that deflects off him. Shot and a goal! Carson Pratt capitalizes on that Swarm mistake, and we have a 1-1 game.
Yeah, Barakauskas playing a little bit of a hospital pass, trying to go D-to-D saucer pass on the backhand, but didn't clear that out of danger at all. And the Stampede will snap that one up, and they'll be straight back on the board, 1-1.
Yeah, that took a funny bounce off the shin pads of Mawson and just was placed in the perfect position where Carson Pratt could come in and bury that puck just off the pipe and in on far side to Perry. So 16 minutes remaining, and we are all square. Now play to the far side, it's Polozov. On the chase, played up and finally out, but Chalice is there to corral it. Puck taken from him by McIntosh. And then over to Freer. He'll go D to D. And now back to Freer. Freer will dump it in the zone. And it'll be Harrison to chase, but Perry will play that along the wall. And it's up towards Polozov. That's taken from him by Strayer. Strayer over to McIntosh. Tried to leave it for Harrison, but that was in his skates. And it's finally played out of the zone. Freer will dump it towards Andrew Hay. Hay will instead play it back towards his D-man Sandoy. And then up the wall towards Iacenza, but Harrison McCog's on his back and forcing him the other way. Iacenza with the puck, avoids a big hit from McIntosh, and then will decide to skate it up himself and finally drag down from behind. But no call on the play. And now here's a chance for Harrison in front, but he couldn't quite get much on that. And then he took a big hit in front as well. And there's a shot that just missed as it's deflected off the netting.
It's definitely hitting up here now, folks.
Now Polozov loses control of the puck and forcing Perry to come out and cover it. As that was dangerous with two Stampede players hoping to pounce on it.
Yeah, Stampede player wide open in front of the net there for a couple of seconds. As Andy Hay had slipped and hit the deck. So a bit of a scare there for the Botany Swarm, but they won't do too much damage to Stampede on that, as they'll get the number one line back out there.
Yeah, always dangerous in the own zone for sure when you're not controlling the puck as well as you should. So it'll be Logan Fraser with the puck on the far side. He leaves the puck there for Janssen, and it's played back to Chung. Chung will go to Iacenza. Ice sends it back to Chung. He'll try to go the near side here. He's looking for Fraser, but a little bit of a miscommunication there. And now the stampede the other way. Schneider plays it down low, and it's Chung, the first man there. He'll go along the wall towards Janssen, off his skate. And then McEwen comes in to rescue the puck. McEwen tries to chip it out, but a nice play by Volt to keep that in. And then Braden Lee with the puck. Here's Schneider in the slot, goes back door for Volpe. And I don't know if Perry got a piece of that, but if so, that was a huge save because Volpe was all alone in front with a lot of twine to see.
Well, I don't think Perry did get anything on that. Just must be the curve on Volpe's stick. He sent that way over the crossbar. Almost wide open net, it seemed.
Yeah, the defenseman probably doesn't find himself that close to the opposing net very often. And the refs are saying that he did just put that up over the glass by himself without any assistance from Perry. So Hay will get the puck as Max McCaug puts a check on him. And now back to Max McCaug, but Hay with a good recovery to poke the stick away from him. And now Kozak has it. And it looks like Max McCaug got a little too close to the net there, trying to curve up ice, and knocks it loose, so we will get a whistle.
Yeah, Stampede coming out even better once again this period. They're looking more dangerous as the game does go on. Swarm still looking relatively sharp, but both teams are evenly matched here now.
So Josh Hay will play center here against Max McCaug, and Hay wins it to Sandoy. Now up to Kozak across the line. He makes a stop, trying to find Vortanov, but was only able to find the stick of Max McCaug. Now back up towards Sandoy. He tried to leave it towards Hay, but no one home, and True will play that up. Now back to Sandoy. Again, they're getting a little close to the net here, and the net is ajar, but play continues as the ref refuses to blow the whistle. And we're out of the zone. It's Josh Hay. Hay across the line, slap shot right on, and a rebound is cleared. And finally out. And now a whistle. I'm not sure what this whistle was for, Bryce.
Yeah, I don't have too much of an idea too there, Doc. The ref explaining something to a few of the players.
He certainly had a great opportunity to blow the whistle earlier as the net was loose, but instead let them play on, which led to a shot the other end for the Swarm, and then a mystery whistle on that rebound. So it's played up towards Mawson. He'll leave it for Polozov. Polozov curls towards the net and then is going into the far wall. Polozov takes two defenders to get the puck off him, but he's still fighting for it and now regains control. Takes a hit there from Harrison. And then finally Harrison gets control of the truck, tries to bat it out, but instead back to the stick of Polozov, who seems to have that thing on a string.
Now, yeah, Polozov, absolute workhorse he is for the Swarm.
So strong in his skates. Just a... Not necessarily as tall as any of the players out there, but certainly just as thick.
Yeah, he's got great agility and great puck control. But he's always able to shake and bake his man and try to get past the defense line.
So faceoff was out of the zone on that Mawson shot that went over the glass. And now played into the zone. And up towards Iacenza, but Freer was able to step up there and break up the pass, but McEwen's able to recover. Centering feet here, he was looking for Janssen crashing towards the net, but he was unable to get any wood on it.
Yeah, good opportunity there for Johnson, just unable to get anything on it.
And now it'll be Schneider. Schneider makes a move around Fraser, but then a good play by Iacenza to steal the puck from him. And he'll play it up into the zone. And Schneider's the first man there. He'll look back towards Freer, but that's just in front of him, and that'll be all the way down for an ice.
Schneider almost as good going backwards as he is going forward, with good pressure and back check on to chase Iacenza as he did dispossess him, but didn't give up on the play.
Absolutely. He's got some long strides to deal with as well. definitely a force here in the NZIHL. So Swarm with the draw. It's Hay, a long shot that's deflected just wide past stick side of the goaltender Murray and into the near corner. It's Hay with the puck now. Hay looking up towards Vortanov. Vortanov from the top of the slot as he's pressured by Freer, and he'll just throw it down in the corner towards Kozak. Kozak with it now. He goes back towards Vortanov, but that's past him, and Josh Hay will collect. Hay with some pressure from Freer, tried to leave it towards Vortanov, but Schneider was able to step up into that and send it all the way down the length of the ice, but no icing as that puck just slowed up as it crossed the lead line.
Oh,
here's a dangerous pass intercepted by Freer. Now Freer the other way from a sharp angle, right on, but Perry is there to make the save.
Yeah, somewhat dangerous pass there as Freer could have maybe, would have liked to do a little bit better trying to control that puck, but he did get a little bit on it to keep it in the zone, but he could have done a lot more, and it could have been a very dangerous situation there for the Botany Swarm.
So Badarkauskas will get the puck. You play it over towards Polozov. Polozov tried to chip it up and actually got into the face of Max McCaug. Oh, I'm sorry, that is the defender.
Dunford.
Bit of an unlucky play off the stick there. It looks like he took it right in the mouth, but he's a hockey player and he will continue.
Yeah, they'll definitely wake you up a bit there, Dr. J. But Dunford will be back out there like nothing happened. Good battler he is.
So because the whistle was blown for an injury here to Dunford, he will be forced to leave the ice. Checking the chicklets out there, they all seem to be in order. And it will be Max McCaug to take the draw against Chalice, and Chalice wins it. Over to Polozov, who spins out of one defender and leaves it to Chalice. Now far side, it's Mawson. Mawson tries to play it up towards Ball. Was up in his midsection, goes right down to his stick. His shot, though, misses everything, and it goes to Chalice. Chalice has it now in the near wall. He tried to centering feed towards Casey Ball, but Freer was able to get a stick in front of that. And then played down towards Freer again. And the Stampede will get a change here with just 10 minutes remaining here in the third period. Chalice avoided a hit and then made a move around Carson Pratt and plays it over to Badarkauskas. Badarkauskas takes it into the zone and just leaves the puck there, and Volpe will have it. And now Volpe with some speed up ice. He was able to get around Iacenza. No one to help out in front, so he'll just turn away. Trying to get up towards McIntosh, but that's intercepted by Iacenza. And then Connor Harrison was able to break that up. And the play is whistled down as the puck deflected up into the ceiling.
Yeah, some good end-to-end stuff here lately. Could go either way here, I think, Doc. But
yeah, tight game. Definitely two well-matched squads here.
You feeling a bit of overtime?
Oh, I'd say we're still 9 minutes and 40 seconds away from that.
It's not never too early to start thinking about it. I always do love myself a bit of extra hockey. Make sure the fans get their money worth.
Perry had to make two saves on that shot as it popped up, and he was able to blocker it to safety. Now over to the near side, it's Freer. His shot towards the net misses everything. Back door is Logan Fraser to clear it. That out of harm's way, but a good play by Volpe to step up and keep it in. Now a centering feed looking for Harrison, but that went off a skate, and it's the Swarm the other way. Iacenza now leaves it for McEwen. McEwen back towards Iacenza, trying to do a little give and go action there, but some good defense by the Stampede to get some sticks on pucks.
Man, Volpe seems like he's forever out there for the Stampede.
Yeah, he's got some deep lungs and takes some long shifts, and he's a great defenseman too, so an advantage there for the Stampede.
I'd almost fancy him as being an attacker instead.
He seems to be everywhere at some point. So it's Strayer on the far wall. He's got plenty of room, so he'll just skate it up himself using those streaking skates of his, and he'll throw it into the near corner over towards Vortanov. Vortanov with a backhand no-look pass towards Hay. Now a shot right on. Great tip there by Schneider to deflect that on goal, but Perry was in great position to save and hold on.
Yeah, Daniel Lee seeing Schneider cutting back in, and Schneider getting a great tip on it.
Dangerous play from one of the top point getters here in the NZIHL.
As Jealous will go to work now against Schneider.
It will be Schneider, Lee, and McCog for the Stampede, won by Schneider. Up to Dunford, his shot hit a shin pad. Another chance, looks like that hit Harrison McCog as he was unable to get out of the way of that blast from True. Now it's Schneider with the puck across the blue. He's looking for McCog, but that deflects out, and it's Dunford the first one there. Dunford up to McCog. Polozov with a hit to knock the puck free, but it's scooped up by Schneider. Now Schneider, you leave it for True. True with all day, decides to skate it himself. He gets across the red, tries to dump it in, but that's broken up by Ball. Ball trying to make a play the other way, but once again, Schneider doing a great job to get back and break that up.
Yeah, that was really close there with Polozov lurking down the middle, but Ball just unable to get that pass off as Schneider was doing, once again, a great back check.
So Schneider again with the puck. He'll try to get around Polozov, but Polozov got a piece of him. Looks like their legs collided on that, which could have been a dangerous play. And it looks like we will get a penalty here for interference. So that will put the Stampede on the power play here with 7:14 remaining in this third period as Chalice goes off for that 2-minute minor for interference.
A great opportunity coming up here for the Stampede. After tying it back up, they'll get their number one line out there with Schneider, Strayer, Volp, and Amston. Also with McIntosh, it seems.
Schneider once again wins the draw. Now it's over to Amston. Amston skates in, and a shot and glove saved by Perry as he saw that all the way.
Great game from the goalies so far here, Doc.
I would say that's the story of the game, really. Perry has been absolutely outstanding, as has his counterpart in Murray, keeping this just a 1-1 game. So Dunford now at the point. He gets around Iacenza and then skates towards the net. Centering feed there goes through, and it's Volp with the puck. Volp tries to play it up towards Dunford, but that's intercepted by McEwen, and now shorthanded, he's got some speed. Gets around his man, shot, tried to go across his body, glove side, but just missed the net.
Yeah, great opportunity there for Corey McEwen.
Now here's some trouble as three Swarm players were up ice. Now McIntosh, shot right on, but Perry is there and he holds on. Bit of an offensive-minded penalty kill here from the Swarm as they had three players up ice and just the lone defender and Moss in there to try to defend that 3-on-1. So it'll be Schneider again to take the draw against Kozak, and he wins it to Strayer. Now Dunford, he skates towards the net. He puts a shot that just missed wide as he was allowed to creep right below the circles. Now another shot attempt from Dunford that's blocked, and it's Josh Hay. He'll just scoot it down himself and then go on to chase. So it's played over towards Josh, but he did not have his head up as the puck was actually coming his way. Instead, it'll be McIntosh who skates it. He tries to get around Kozak, and then now Fraser. McIntosh still with the puck. You play it up top to Volp, and now Amston. Amston slots towards Schneider. Schneider puts one right on, as Lee was in front and Perry had to make a nice stick save on that. And then Fraser will clear the puck all the way down and it'll be Amston and Kozak. Kozak tried to make a hit there but missed everything and the Stampede are the other way. Schneider here, one-on-one with Sandoy, trying to get around him and instead plays it up to Amston. Amston with a slap shot from the blue. Come to the near side, there's a shot and a huge save by Rick Perry, diving across an open goal to keep that one out.
Now that is an incredible save there by Perry, getting across to cover up the wide open man at the back post.
Volp was wide open all alone with plenty of net to shoot at once again, but this time it took a diving goalie in Perry to keep that out. You hate to see your goalie make a desperation save like that, but when the result keeps the puck out, you don't really care how it looks.
Yeah, I don't think Volpe was able to corral that puck too nicely on the first attempt. So it just slowed him down to get the shot off.
So still on the power play here for another 4 seconds. And it's over to Freer. Freer going in towards the slot, but that was just off the stick of Harrison. And we're back to 5-on-5 hockey as Chalice is out of the box. Now played behind the net is Connor Harrison. He tried to go between the legs. That's broken up by Moss, and he'll just skate to buy a little bit of time. And another little spin move there. And finally up to Chalice on the near wall. Now Sandoy. Sandoy looks up ice. He'll play it to Polozov. Polozov avoids one defender into the zone and then was able to get around Strayer, but Amston said not this time. And the third time's a charm for the Stampede as they're able to break that up and off the ice. Amston still with a puck, going coast to coast here by Amston, trying to create something happen. Now Harrison for the slot, he shoots, he scores! Connor Harrison beats Perry blocker side, and we have a 2-1 game.
Yeah, great work there by Stefan Amston, taking it from his whole defensive zone, going around the back of the net, and then finding Harrison in the low slot, and he absolutely roofs that one over Perry's blocker.
A great shot from Harrison with some time in the most dangerous part of the ice in front of the net.
Didn't really have his head up to see where he was shooting to, just turned around and quickly shot something on net and picked out a great place.
He just felt it. So just like that, the Swarm will be playing trailing for the first time this game with 4 minutes and 20 seconds to work with. And that play is whistled by the referee, and it looks like we have an icing. Swarm need to manufacture something here because lately it's been all Stampede.
Yeah, Swarm will get their top line out there for this time, but they'll have Johnson on the right wing.
With Atwell has not returned after suffering that injury this period. Now the near wall, it's Strayer. Tried to chip that one over to McIntosh just in front of him, so he'll have to take some time to collect it. Gets around a hip check from McEwen, then puts on the brakes as Freer was taken down in front by Sandoy. And now played up, there's a shot right on, tipped by McIntosh, but Perry was all over that. And now Andrew Hay gets the puck taken from him by Harrison McCaug. Nice play there by McCaug to try to create something out of nothing with his teammates changing. Now Sandoy will play it over towards Iacenza. Iacenza with some speed. He'll get it into the zone. Gets around two defenders. Looking for a centering pass there. Shot, oh, just missed by Josh Hay as he was unable to get strong lumber on that. But another good opportunity for the Swarm.
Yeah, absolute great opportunity there. Just unable to get enough from the shot.
Great defensive play to prevent Hay from getting much on that. Now Hay again with the puck. He'll play it over to Fraser. Fraser puts one towards Vortanoff, but that's behind him, and Kozak will have to chase. Now back towards Vortanoff. Now played up and out by Braden Lee. The length of the ice, but no icing here as the puck slows up. Fraser's the man back. He'll play it up towards Kozak. Kozak up to Chalice. Chalice now, he'll put on the brakes. Looking to find Vortanoff in the near corner, but that's broken up by Amston, and then he'll just chip it off the wall up towards Max McCaug. That's ahead of him, and it comes back to Chalice. Chalice now on the near side to Ball. Ball trying to get it back to Chalice, but had to get through four Stampede players, and instead it'll come up towards Max McCaug. Now behind the net, it's Mawson with it. Mawson looking up towards Chalice, but Dunford is there in front of that, and he'll send it right back towards Sandoy.
Just under 2 minutes to go now here. The Swarm gonna have to get back into this one real fast.
Now played over towards Mawson. He's looking for Ball. Ball into the zone. He'll play it towards Polozov, who deflects that right on goal, forcing Murray to make a glove save. So 1 minute 44 remaining. And we'll see how much longer Perry stays in there before they try to pull him for the extra attacker.
probably a good opportunity now for the Swarm to actually call a timeout and get a breather and talk about it, but they will elect to stay on the front foot here.
So it'll be Polozov on the top line here with McEwen and Iacenza. Double shifting the always in shape Alex Polozov. And play up to the line, but Mawson does a real nice job to keep that in. And the Swarm continue their attack. Now played down low, Polozov bats that out of midair, and then McIntosh loses the twig. Now there's a shot right on towards Polozov, and a huge save, still loose, rebound, and we have a whistle. Wow, what a fantastic save there, as just the paddle of the stick was the only thing keeping the puck out.
And Murray knew all about that second, that save as well. Wow. These goalies are putting on a hell of a show here tonight.
It has been entertaining. That is for certain. I'm not sure the cause of that whistle, as the puck was still loose. But nonetheless, we have a face-off to the left here of Murray.
Swarm were intensely close on that goal-scoring opportunity.
So just over a minute remaining here. Perry still in goal here for the Swarm. It'll be Sandoy with the puck. He'll stop behind the net. Plays it up to Mawson. Now Mawson with some room. Skates it himself across the blue line.
And Perry comes out of net.
Centering feed here. And then Chalice. A little confusion there with Perry coming off. And the Swarm a little sloppy with the puck in the own end, which is dangerous when you don't have a goalie there. Now played up toward Iacenza. Iacenza trying to split the D, but Volpe is able to finally close the gap, and it's up towards Schneider. Schneider bounces it off the wall to Harrison, and now two on one with no goalie. Harrison shoots and misses everything, but he's got his teammate Strayer there. Centering feed towards Harrison, but Sandoy is back to break up the play, and just 20 seconds remaining here. And now Chalice, he'll play it over to Mawson, who looks pretty tired, but he's got 15 seconds and needs to make something happen. Mawson on the near side tries to centering feed, but Freer was able to get a piece of that. Now center there, and Volpe steers it away. Polozov has it, and has finally cleared the length of the ice and just wide for an icing, but that is of no consequence, as that will wrap up the third period and the Stampede take the opener here in a thrilling 2-1 victory.
Yeah, incredible game here from both sides here this evening. Stampede coming out on top, but they didn't look like they would at the very start of the game, as the Swarm were all over them. But improving every period, they got a goal back in the two goals in this final period, and then eventually took the lead and won.
A thrilling game end to end here, as the Swarm came out early and got that one goal. However, that was the only goal they scored, as the Stampede fought back to score two unanswered, and Connor Harrison with the winner late in this third period.
If this is a preview for the finals, Doc, I'm pretty excited.
I'm right there with you, but remember, we still have a play-in game to be had, so this will give the Stampede a little bit of breathing room, putting them 8 points clear of the Swarm, alone in first place, and that win could really go a long way to help clinch that number one overall seed.
Yeah, absolutely. The Swarm really needed two wins here this weekend if they were to try to take top spot, as then they would probably have to rely on the Admirals beating the Stampede next weekend.
And as the Stampede have shown, they are not an easy team to beat, with the Swarm accounting for their only loss.
Yes, that was earlier in the season, and they look like they're turning it on again and looking hot coming into the finals, so you never know.
Indeed, you never do, and that's why we play the games. So thanks for tuning in, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we do. We have the conclusion of this two-game series tomorrow here in Botany. Same time, same rink, and we'll hope for some of the same action. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. J, alongside Bryce Rouse. We'll catch you next time.
Thank you, everybody, and good night.